quite finish last night, so this is a new day, new clothes, but back to 4.1, part B. But before we start, part A, I got the sign wrong. Li is alpha r minus 1 minus alpha L bar over tau. Obviously, tau 1 minus tau. Obviously, you raise tau, you reduce labor, you don't increase it. I managed to slip in a plus sign there before. Okay, so what are we doing in part B? We are told to work out what tax the regulator should actually choose to implement, knowing that the tax will reduce labor. There are approximately 1,723 ways of solving this. But I think perhaps the most logical thing to do is take it in two steps and first work out, given the utility function, what amount of labor does the regulator want to achieve, because that's the only variable. And then, having worked out that, then work out what tax yields the optimal amount of labor. And so that's what we're going to do. We're going to start by working out the quantity of labor. To do that, we go here. And the key insight is that whatever the quantity of labor that is chosen, everyone's going to do the same. And Ci and C bar are going to be equal, and this is going to be 1. So in equilibrium, when everyone does the same, Ci equals C bar, and let's just call that C. And Li equals L bar, let's just call that L. And Ui equals U bar equals U. So then we can write U is C to the alpha 1, R to the 1 minus alpha. Alpha is alpha 1 plus alpha 2. And then we use this, that R is big R minus L. And C is L times 1 minus tau plus L times tau. C is just L. So U is L to the alpha 1 R minus L to the 1 minus alpha. What choice of L maximizes U? Very straightforward. Du dL is alpha 1 U over L plus 1 minus alpha U over R minus L. 1 minus alpha times everything over R minus L, and then we go inside and differentiate and get a minus sign. Equals 0. Okay, so I'm going to cheat a bit, put a colon there, shift this to the other side to put an equal sign there, and cancel the U's. Get that. Okay, so that's pretty straightforward. From there, we get here. Now I'm going to multiply through by L to bring the L up here, and I'm going to multiply through by R minus L. So we have alpha 1 R minus L equals 1 minus alpha L. Collect terms in L, and we have that L is equal to alpha 1. L, we brought this one over, and we've got alpha 1 R left, and then we need to divide through by 1 minus alpha plus alpha 1, which is 1 minus alpha 1 minus alpha 2 plus alpha 1, that's 1 minus alpha 2. Okay. So far, so good. It's alpha 2 R. And I do believe we can wipe this out. Okay, so the next question is, what value do we choose for Tor to achieve this value of L? And the answer is to be found here. Because remember, Li equals L bar equals L. So now we have L equals alpha R minus 1 minus alpha L Tor over 1 minus Tor. Okay. But L is alpha 1 over 1 minus alpha 2 times R. So we can stick that in, and if you see we have, well, why don't we start by dividing through by R. Then we have alpha and L over R and L over R. Okay, so now we have L over R is alpha minus 1 minus alpha L over R, Tor over 1 minus Tor. But L over R is alpha 1 over 1 minus alpha 2. So we have alpha 1 over 1 minus alpha 2 equals alpha minus 1 minus alpha alpha 1 over 1 minus alpha 2 Tor over 1 minus Tor. Okay, and I've written this kind of weird because I'm now going to multiply through by 1 minus alpha 2 to get cancel, cancel, 1 minus alpha 2. Okay, so now we've got an equation with the only variable in it is Tor. We're almost there. I'm happier than you here because I've tried this. I've been doing this a few times and I always screw up. Hopefully this time it's going to work. Okay. So let's collect terms. We take this over this side to get a plus positive. So we have 1 minus alpha, alpha 1, Tor over 1 minus Tor equals. We take this alpha 1 over to this side, and we need to open out this alpha, I think. Yeah, we're going to have to open this one up. So we've got alpha 1 plus alpha 2 times 1 minus alpha 2 minus alpha 1. Okay. Hold your thumbs, keep your fingers crossed. I think this is going to work. When we multiply this out, we have alpha 1 plus alpha 2, that's that bit, minus alpha 1 alpha 2 minus alpha 2 squared, and then that's that, then minus alpha 1, which means we can wipe this. So that's that. And for that, we can take out alpha 2, can't we? We've got alpha 2s everywhere here. So we've got alpha 2 times 1 minus alpha 1 minus alpha 2, which is alpha! No, it's... Sorry, this is alpha. So this is 1 minus alpha. Yes! So Tor over 1 minus Tor, 1 minus alpha, alpha 1 is alpha 2 times 1 minus alpha. These cancel out. Tor over 1 minus Tor is alpha 2 over alpha 1. Now, multiply through by 1 minus tor. Tor equals alpha 2 over alpha 1, 1 minus tor. Collect terms in tor. Tor times 1 plus alpha 2 over alpha 1 equals alpha 2 over alpha 1. But what's this? This is alpha 1 over alpha 1 plus alpha 2 over alpha 1. So that's tor times alpha 1 plus alpha 2 over alpha 1 equals alpha 2 over alpha 1. And it's worked. The alpha 1s go out. And we have tor equals alpha 2 over alpha 1 plus alpha 2, which is the correct answer. Okay. Why does this make sense? Okay. What if alpha 2 is 0? What tax do you apply? Then you apply no tax. When alpha 2 is 0, there's no externality. Okay. What if alpha 2 is 1? If alpha 2 is 1, then alpha 1 has to be 0, doesn't it? Because the if alpha 2 is 1, alpha 1 has to be 0. Because they can't add up to more than 1, these two. So that means that all you care about is relative consumption. You don't care at all about your own absolute consumption, and you don't care at all about leisure. When that's the case, and the limit, tax is 1. When the relative consumption is totally dominant and people can't win this race, you tax them completely and give them back the public goods to stop them working like crazy. Okay, or in general, well actually, yeah, what makes more sense is put alpha 1 equal to 0. So as soon as then, this makes more sense. When alpha 1 is 0, you still care about leisure. All you care about is leisure and relative consumption. But then, what you should do is stop people working altogether then, so they have all the same consumption, 0, and loads of leisure. That's when people are going to be happiest in this model, when alpha 1 is 0. The absolute level of consumption has absolutely no bearing on their utility. So you should tax them in such a way as to stop them working, which is to set the tax equal to 1. You take everything they earn. If we put that in here, you should then get that labor tax is 1, so this is 1 over naught, that's infinity. So labor is like alpha r minus infinity, which is the only way to make this work is to make L. See, nobody's going to work. Okay, it's the only thing that doesn't lead to a contradiction. L is 0. Okay, and that's the end.